Introduction to Vividata. This introductory guide is focused on creating and interpreting simple tables. Vividata is an industry organization created through a partnership between Canadian media organizations and Canadian advertisers. They pull Canadians to gather the data needed to answer the perennial questions of advertisers and publishers. Questions about what products and services Canadians are buying, what are their ages, incomes, and other demographic characteristics? What are their opinions about such topics as recycling, shopping, traveling, and dieting? Vividata's survey of the Canadian consumer reaches over 40,000 Canadians each year and produces detailed data on Canadians' opinions, demographics, and activities, as well as their product, service, and media purchases. The Vividata database, available via the library, allows you to connect those puzzle pieces in many ways to answer different questions. For instance, what energy drinks do female millennials drink most often? Which province has the most people who attend pro hockey games? Are frequent gardeners likely to be open to trying new food products? And are hybrid car owners likely to pay more for products that elevate their status? Creating a table. We can create a Vividata table in four main parts. A, identifying splits and questions. B, select the split. C, select the question. And D, final steps. We can demonstrate how to search Vividata by using a sample question. Are Canadian Red Bull drinkers more likely to be millennials, Generation Xers, or baby boomers? A, identify splits and questions. We will use the category of splits and questions to construct our table. Splits represent our target portion of the population. Think of this as the group about whom we want to know something. In this case, it's Canadian Red Bull drinkers. More specifically, we are interested in learning something about the Canadians who are 14 years or older, who claim that Red Bull is the energy drink brand they purchase most often. Question. The information we would like to have about our target group, our split. In this case, we want to know how many people in our split are in each of these major generational cohorts, millennials, Generation Xers, and baby boomers. B, select the split. Step 1, choose the cross table option from the top banner. Step 2, search for energy or browse the food and beverage category to find beverages, energy, sport drinks, energy brands drink, MSTOFT. This refers to a question from the survey relating to energy sport drinks that may ask something like, what energy sport drink brands do you drink most often? In most cases, you will need to first search for product types, not brand names. Specific brands can be selected in a later step. Step 3. Cursor over your chosen topic and select Add as Split from the options that appear. Step 4. Deselect or turn off the nest variable splits option so that the default all respondents 14 plus split is to the left of the energy brand split. This will be important later. We'll benchmark our chosen split, Red Bull drinkers, against the population listed in the first column, all 14 plus. Step 5. Click on the three small circles to open a list of brands available for this topic. Then select Red Bull from that list. You could hold down the control key and select multiple brands, but we're keeping this sample table simple by focusing on just the single brand split. C. Select the question. Step 6. Search or browse to find the age generation demographic variable. Then cursor over it and add it as a question to your table. Besides demographics, you will find Vividata to be rich with psychographics, which are found within personal characteristics slash views. It is worth your time to browse through the categories to see the many areas available. Step 7. Delete the default question, all respondents, 14 plus, as it isn't needed for the topic we are researching, but leave the default 14 plus split. Again, we are aiming for simplicity for this sample table. It's fine to include multiple questions in a more complex table. D. Final steps. Step 8. Click on the Calculations tab. Step 9. Then select the option to Enable Benchmark Calculation and adjust the calculation option to Index Conversion Rate. These benchmark settings will make it easier to interpret the table. Our next step. If you haven't done so already, click on the Generate tab to display the table we designed in the last section. If all went well, you should now see the table. This simple table, with just 20 cells and 26 numbers, is packed with information about the ages of Red Bull drinkers, the drink choices of different generations, and the survey response counts of those in three major generational cohorts. Remember when we created our search? We enabled the benchmark calculation. In our view, benchmarking is one of the most powerful and useful features of Vividata. Enabling benchmarking will let you see whether one group is more or less likely than another group for a particular variable to apply to them. When you turn on benchmarking, by default, all columns will be compared against the first column. Let's break down the first column of this table because that is the column we will compare Red Bull drinkers against. The count is the number of people in the population projected to have positively responded to the question. All counts in a table are weighted. Because of this, all counts, with the exception of the unweighted base, in other words, the sample size, can be multiplied by 1,000. The unweighted base can be read as a straight number. From the first column, we learned that the survey sample size consisted of 38,310 respondents who fit within the millennial, Gen Xer, or baby boomer cohorts. Each person in the sample is projected to represent a certain number of people in the population. When projected onto the Canadian population, the 38,310 respondents represent 28,458,000 Canadians in the millennial, Gen Xer, or baby boomer cohorts. Next, we read that of the 28,458,000, approximately 34%, or 9,737,700, are millennials. Having enabled benchmarking, we can compare whether one generation is more or less likely than another to drink Red Bull. Let's look at the right column to continue with comparative interpretations. Of the 38,310 survey respondents, 384 of them said that Red Bull is the brand of energy drink that they drink most often. This represents approximately 308,000 consumers in the millennial, Gen X, and baby boomer categories who most often drank Red Bull. Of all the people who reported that Red Bull is the energy drink brand that they consume most often, 43.3% are millennials. However, only 34.2% of those in the three major age generational cohorts are millennials. So major Red Bull drinkers are more likely to be millennials than you might expect given that generation's share of the population. Next, we'll look at numbers relating to the likelihood index. This number tells us if a group is more or less likely for a particular variable to apply to them. It is measured relative to average Canadians, which is always 100, with more than 100 read as more likely and less than 100 as less likely. And so, if we continue in the right column with our interpretation, we learn from the 126.4 index value that our Red Bull group is roughly 26.4% more likely to be of the millennial age group than is the average population to be millennial. Conversely, of all the Canadian millennials represented by this survey, 9,737,700, only 1.4% state that Red Bull is the brand of energy drink they consume most often. As we've seen through examples from this one table, Vividata allows us to connect the puzzle pieces in many ways to answer different questions about Red Bull consumers. This concludes our introduction to creating and interpreting simple tables from Vividata. For further help, please contact the library. Thanks for watching.